I'm Dr. Irma Williams, Irma Ruth Williams, and I'm a board-certified anesthesiologist. I am working now in Asheville, North Carolina, which is where I was born, with the Veterans Administration Medical Center here in Asheville. I chose anesthesiology as a profession because I realized my personality and my particular skills were very good with that specialty. When I was a small child, 2 to 3 years old, my brother was born and he had cerebral palsy. My mother was B negative and my father A positive blood, so that is a problem before they had Rogaine, and many children were born with damage from that. So before I was in kindergarten, I was going to be a doctor. I was going to make a difference for somebody. My brother was very smart and had a really funny sense of humor, and I saw him go through everything he went through, and I wanted to be the kind of person that changed people's lives, like the doctors that had worked with him. One person that took a great interest in me was Dr. Michael Roizen. His philosophy of anesthesia and of treating patients really struck me as coinciding with mine. My next real mentor was Henry Banks. Dr. Henry Banks had worked with polio, and he was one of the first at Tufts New England Medical Center. Actually, he had started out at Harvard, but I worked under him. At that point, I had lived in Atlanta, San Antonio, Landstuhl, Germany, Charleston in Columbia, South Carolina, and always near military. And part of military bases where all of my background was living with people of different races and nationalities. To be a board certified anesthesiologist to begin with, you have to go 4 years to college, 4 years to medical school, 4 years of residency. And at the end of that, when you're approved, then you're able to sit for the boards, which 1 year you do the written, and a year later you sit for oral boards. All surgical specialties, to be board certified, you have to do both written and oral boards. There are several issues that make a great deal of difference in anesthesia and being able to take good care of our patients. Of course, for one thing, we make surgery possible. And in doing that, when we have very sick patients, we have so much cardiovascular disease with aging, we have so much diabetes, we have the issues of obesity that adds challenges to what we do. And then added to that, we have all the new technology that we need more time, more resources, more continuing education so that we can make sure we keep up with all of this knowledge. The VA has patients from a fairly young age to very elderly. We, of course, still have a number of World War II veterans, which are our greatest generation, and that, of course, is what my father was. He had been both in World War II and in the Korean conflict. You know, every time I have been asked what is the most rewarding part of my job, it's really the people. It's one case at a time. It's each thing that we do to improve people's lives, and then the ones that are really challenging, well then that also improves our knowledge and our skills. So it's one case at a time, one day at a time, one person at a time. From the very beginning, I wanted to do some mission work. So I very excitedly planned to go to India. The things that we learned, the appreciation we got from the patients was just remarkable. What I want to do with my life is improve other people's lives, and that is the most important thing to me. And it's kind of a little more flashy to do it on a missionary trip. And I would hope that I will be able to do more and more of that as time goes on.